The battle between these three cards is going to be intense. Hey everyone, it's Mark. I'm here to help you put more money in your pocket through credit cards and smart financial habits. If that sounds good to you, then do me a quick favor and click on the like and subscribe button down below. Also, be sure to check out the links in the description below. There are several ones down there to apply for a new credit card, to get 4 free stocks from Webull when you open a new account and deposit $100, and to start your own online business and have me guide you through the process. Check them out. Now, I've got 3 very powerful credit cards up here on today's center stage: the American Express Platinum Card, the Marriott Bonvoy Brilliant Card, and the Hilton Honors Aspire Card. All 3 of these cards have insanely sky-high annual fees and a long list of perks, benefits, and VIP features that come with each one as well. And since they're all issued by American Express with some overlapping benefits between them, a lot of people wonder, which one should I get, if any at all, or should I get 2 or all 3 of them? So to help you all out, we're going to do a full comparison of these cards, and here's how we're going to do it. We'll begin by looking at the sign-up bonuses as of January 2021, then we'll discuss the earning and redeeming points capabilities for each card, then go over the main benefits. After that, we'll move into a side-by-side comparison and finish with determining which card is best for you and which one you might want to get. And if that agenda sounds good to you, then let's get to it. We'll kick things off with the American Express Platinum Card. The sign-up bonus as of January 2021 is ridiculous. It's one of the best ones in history for this card, and you will earn 100,000 membership rewards points after spending $5,000 in the first 6 months of card membership. You'll also receive the ability to earn 10 points per dollar at U.S. gas stations and U.S. supermarkets on up to $15,000 of combined purchases for the first 6 months. The value of those 100,000 points varies based on how you use those points, but it can be anywhere from about $600 up to around $2,000 on average, and we'll discuss the differences between those two in just a minute. When it comes to earning points on the Platinum Card, you'll get 5 points per dollar on flights booked directly with the airlines or on AmexTravel.com, and 5 points per dollar on hotels when they are prepaid via AmexTravel.com, which is the Amex Travel portal. Then 1 point per dollar on everything else. The annual fee on this card is $550. That's a lot of money for a piece of plastic, or rather a piece of metal. But since you're paying that for all the perks and benefits and not just the card itself, it can be worth it for the right people. We'll keep on going. When it comes to redeeming your points, there's a long list of different ways to do so, but I'm going to put the 3 most popular ones that people talk about here on the screen. The first main way, and usually the highest value, is when you redeem your points for travel using the transfer partners. Doing so gives you an average value of around 2 cents per point, so your 100,000 point signup bonus will be worth around $2,000. The second best way to redeem your points is for travel using the Amex Travel portal at AmexTravel.com. There you can get 0.7 cents per point for hotels, car rentals, cruises, and vacation packages, or 1 cent per point toward flights. This allows your 100,000 point signup bonus to be worth $700 or $1,000, depending on what you choose. Then you can redeem for cashback via statement credit, giving you 0.6 cents per point. That's where your 100,000 point signup bonus will be worth $600. Now, since transfer partners tend to be the way you get the most value for your points, here's a list of the current transfer partners that American Express has, including the airlines and the hotels. In order to achieve around 2 cents per point on average for your points, the best way to do it is on premium cabins with international carriers. Feel free to pause this screen if you'd like to look at these transfer partners in more detail. Now, the list of benefits on the Platinum Card are insane. So if you're paying that $550 annual fee, this is how you justify it. You will receive a PayPal credit up to $180. That's broken down to $30 per month from January through June 2021. You also get Uber rides with Platinum, $200 per year. That's broken down into a $15 monthly credit toward Uber and Uber Eats, and then $35 of credit in December. There's also an airline fee credit, $200 per year. You choose one airline and it covers incidental charges. Then there's up to $100 credit to cover global entry and TSA PreCheck applications every 4.5 years. A $100 shop sats with Platinum credit, giving you $50 January through June, and another $50 July through December when you shop in Saks Fifth Avenue department stores or at Saks.com. Then there's the Global Lounge Collection, which gives you the most comprehensive airport lounge access of any car that you can apply for on the market today. You can get into the Centurion Lounge, the Delta Sky Club, Priority Pass Lounges, Escape Lounges, and Airspace Lounges. Next on the list is the International Airline Program, giving you access to lower fares than you'd be able to book elsewhere, up to 8 tickets per booking. The Hotel Collection, giving you a $100 property credit and room upgrades at a variety of different hotels and brands across the world. The Fine Hotels and Resorts Program, giving you experience credits, room upgrades, daily breakfast for two, early check-in, late checkout, and free Wi-Fi at a bunch of different upscale and luxury properties across the world. Actual elite status with Marriott, Hilton, National Rental Car, and others. And there are no foreign transaction fees on this card. Platinum card? Done. Now let's move on to the Marriott Bonvoy Brilliant card. The signup bonus as of January 2021 is 125,000 points, and here's how that's broken down. You'll get your first 100,000 points after spending $5,000 in the first 3 months of card membership, then an additional 25,000 points after your first anniversary. You'll also receive Platinum Elite status with the Marriott Bonvoy program, and that will be effective from February 1st, 2021 through January 31st, 2022. The value of those points for the signup bonus is about $900 on average, and do note that this offer expires on January 13th, 2021. When it comes to earning points, you'll get 6 points per dollar at Marriott, 3 points per dollar at US restaurants, 3 points per dollar on flights, and double points on everything else. The annual fee here is $450. After you've earned a bunch of points and you're ready to redeem them, the best value will be for Marriott hotels, where you get an average value of about 0.8 cents per point. So as an example, 125,000 points for that welcome bonus will be worth around $1,000. This card also has a nice long list of perks and benefits, including Marriott Bonvoy Gold status, that is complimentary with the card with no spend requirement, Marriott Bonvoy Platinum status that can be earned by spending $75,000 per year on the card. But of course, if you get the card within the next 2 days, you can actually get that Platinum status with no spend requirement at all as part of the signup bonus. You're also going to be getting 15 Elite Night credits every year with this card to help you earn the next level of Elite status faster. A free night award that is totally complimentary, again, no spend requirement, that can be valued up to 50,000 Marriott Bonvoy points. A $300 Marriott Bonvoy statement credit for eligible purchases. Then there's a $100 Marriott Bonvoy property credit where you stay 2 consecutive nights or more at a Ritz-Carlton or a St. Regis property. A $100 credit for global entry or TSA PreCheck. Complimentary premium Wi-Fi. Priority Pass Select that gives you unlimited visits for you and up to 2 guests and no foreign transaction fees. Marriott Bonvoy Brilliant. On the floor and check. Metal credit cards are fun. Now we have the Hilton Honors Aspire card. The signup bonus as of January 2021 is 150,000 points after spending $4,000 in the first 3 months of card membership. The approximate value here is about $900. To earn points, you'll get 14 points per dollar at Hilton properties, 7 points per dollar on flights, car rentals, US restaurants, and then triple points on everything else. The annual fee is $450. When you redeem your points, the best use here will be for Hilton hotels, where your average point value will be around 0.6 cents each. So as an example, your 150,000 signup bonus will be worth about $900. Perks and benefits. You will receive Hilton Honors Diamond status, complimentary with the card, no spend requirement, and up to 2 weekend night rewards. The first night is complimentary in year 1 and every year after you renew the card, and the second night is earned when you spend $60,000 in one calendar year. Then you'll have a few credits, including a $250 resort credit for purchases made at Hilton Resorts, a $250 airline fee credit for incidental charges on one airline, and a $100 Hilton property credit when you stay 2 or more consecutive nights at a Waldorf Astoria or Conrad branded hotel. To top things off, you'll receive a Priority Pass Select membership, giving you unlimited visits to Priority Pass lounges in the airport for you and 2 guests, and no foreign transaction fees on this card, so go ahead and use it abroad where Amex is accepted. Hilton Honors Aspire. Plastic, but a great card. So now that we've gone through all the signup bonuses and how you earn and redeem points and the main benefits of each card, let's put them all side by side to see which one is best for you. Starting with the annual fee. The Platinum card is $550 per year, the Bonvoy Brilliant at $450, and the Hilton Aspire at $450 as well. Then the signup bonuses get a little bit crazy because a couple of them have multiple tiers. Because each card gives you a different amount of points, and because points are worth a different amount individually from one program to the next, at the very bottom in green, I put an approximate average value for this bonus. So for the Platinum card, you're gonna get anywhere from about $600 if you redeem for cashback, or up to around $2,000 for a travel redemption using transfer partners. The Marriott Bonvoy Brilliance bonus will be around $1,000 of value, and the Hilton Honors Aspire will give you about $900. So the clear winner here is the Amex Platinum card, especially if you're doing a travel redemption. And I'll say it's pretty much a tie between the Bonvoy Brilliant and the Hilton Aspire, because 1,000 versus 900, that can be pretty much a wash depending on which property you redeem at, which time of year, etc. Now onto the points. We'll look at the blue section first, which is how you earn points. I did my best to put them in color where they have a common ground. So across the top in the gold color is the hotel earning category. So for the Platinum card, it's 5x on hotels that are prepaid. It does not matter which brand or which company you're with. And then with Marriott and Hilton, it's only for the hotels in those companies' portfolios. So 6x at Marriott, 14x at Hilton. And again, because the average value of a point in each program is totally different, I did my best to convert the average value into a percentage if you were earning cash back. So in cash back terms, the Platinum card would earn you about 10% back on those hotels, the Bonvoy Brilliant at 4.8% return, and the Hilton Honors Aspire at 8.4% return. All three cards have flights as a major earning category. 5x with the Platinum card being 10% back. Triple points on flights for the Bonvoy Brilliant, that's about a 2.4% return. And 7x on flights for the Hilton Aspire, about 4.2% return. Then the two hotel cards on the right-hand side both earn at restaurants. Triple points for the Bonvoy Brilliant at a 2.4% return. And 7x for the Hilton Aspire, a 4.2% return. Only the Hilton Honors Aspire has a car rental category, and they all earn a base level of points on all other purchases. So overall, the clear winner here is the Platinum card with those two 10% categories. And the winner for the greatest return on spend for just the hotel cards would be the Hilton Honors Aspire. Then when you redeem points, the Platinum card has transfer partners with a bunch of different airlines and hotels, including, by the way, the Marriott Bonvoy and Hilton Honors programs. There's also the travel portal, cashback, and gift cards. Your Marriott Bonvoy points will be best used at Marriott hotels and those airline transfer partners that I hinted to earlier, but again, it's a little bit more advanced. We won't go into that right now. And the Hilton points are best for Hilton hotels. Now let's talk about all those crazy benefits. Once again, I color-coded the benefits that the cards have in common, so let's cover those first. Across the top in gold refers to the elite status. The Platinum card gives you elite status with certain hotel companies, namely Marriott and Hilton, funny enough, and a few rental car companies. The Marriott Bonvoy Brilliant card gives you the gold elite status level in the Marriott Bonvoy program, and the Hilton Honors Aspire card gives you diamond elite status in the Hilton Honors program. Now go to the bottom in dark orange or amber. Priority Pass Select is also common across all three cards, giving you access to well over 1,000 different airport lounges across the world. And none of these cards have foreign transaction fees. That's in the bottom in bold black. Now, two things in common between the Platinum card and the Bonvoy Brilliant is in bold gray font. That's the $100 credit toward global entry or TSA PreCheck that becomes available about every 4.5 years. And then between the two hotel cards, I put a dashed gray line or a box around the top four benefits that are almost identical between the cards. So again, both cards give you elite status in the corresponding programs. Both cards give you an annual free night. Both have an annual credit, that's $300 on the Marriott card that covers pretty much all brands, and then the $250 credit on the Hilton side that only works at resort properties. And there's also a $100 property credit that can be used at their top tier properties. Lastly, both the Platinum card and the Hilton Honors Aspire card have an annual airline fee credit in common, that's bold in red. $200 for the Platinum card and $250 for the Hilton Aspire. In terms of which card wins here, I would give my vote to the Platinum card because it has a lot of great perks for travel and also ones that can be used at home. Whereas the other two cards are more geared just toward travel and only within specific programs. Okay, so which of these cards is actually best? I suppose overall, I would say that the Platinum card wins at large for the most amount of perks that can be used broadly. But if you're super loyal to Marriott or Hilton, you might disagree. So what I'm gonna do instead is say which card is best for a particular type of traveler. The Amex Platinum card on the far left is best for frequent travelers who want VIP experience across many brands and flexible travel rewards. The Marriott Bonvoy Brilliant card in the middle is best for frequent travelers who want VIP light experience at Marriott hotels and free nights at Marriott properties. And the Hilton Honors Aspire card on the far right is best for frequent travelers who want full VIP experience at Hilton hotels and resorts and who want free nights at Hilton properties. Now, if you're still wondering which one you should get, if any at all, this will definitely help you out. Get the Amex Platinum card if you spend a lot on flights, hotels, and Uber, travel with many brands, and value a VIP experience and airport lounges. Get the Marriott Bonvoy Brilliant card if you stay at mid-level, upscale, and luxury Marriott hotels, value VIP light, or even full VIP experience at Marriott hotels if you get the sign-up bonus before it expires or are a big spender on the card, and want to earn Marriott Bonvoy points. And lastly, get the Hilton Honors Aspire card if you stay at mid-level, upscale, and luxury Hilton hotels, stay at Hilton Resorts at least one time per year, value full VIP experience at Hilton hotels with that diamond status, and want to earn Hilton Honors points. All of that said, you should avoid all three cards if you are a budget traveler, are a road tripper, don't care about elite status or VIP experiences, don't travel every year, prefer cashback, or if you want to earn a lot of points at home for a big trip later. The exception, of course, is being the one-time sign-up bonus. Getting a lot of points up front is a great way to get those points for a future trip. But I'm talking here about long-term value because none of these cards have good multipliers on gas stations or department stores or supermarkets long-term. So these are not good everyday spend type of cards. And of course, if you just want one huge sign-up bonus to get you on your way to your next trip way faster than you otherwise could without the card, then any of these would be a great bet. That's a wrap for today. If you enjoyed this video and believe it could benefit others, then please help me get it in front of more people by liking this video, subscribing to the channel, and turning on notifications. Also, check out the links in the description below to apply for a new credit card, get 4 free stocks from Webull when you open an account and deposit $100, and if you want to start your own online business and have me guide you through the process, all of that goodness and more is in the description below. I'd also love to know which of these cards you already have in your wallet and which one you most want to apply for next and why. Tell me down below in those comments. Thank you for tuning into today's video. I hope it brought you some great value. I will see you again in future videos. And until then, remember, you are great.